I think I'll go back to Sachin and Azhar, because at that point of time, they were the only two batsmen when we went abroad. You know, at least when you had Sachin and Sehwag, you come down the order as well. You had a couple of batsmen, but that for another day. For the time being, let's go straight to our first management on the show, Vathek Vabag. We have Mr. Rajneesh Chopra, the Global Head of Business Development, who joins us to run us through the numbers. Hi, Mr. Chopra. Thanks so much for joining in. Well, quarter four, the numbers look quite good. Quarter one obviously will be impacted by COVID-19. So we want to understand that in the past quarter, how have the utilization levels been? What is the order inflow that you're looking at for FY21?
Okay. As far as last year is concerned, I think you have seen we have done pretty well on the quarter-on-quarter for the Q4. Although it is a little less than the plan, but I think we have done pretty well considering the COVID situation. Now, the second part of your query is that how do you see this quarter? As far as this quarter is concerned, I think we are into two different segments of business. One is the service business, the other one is the EPC. So as far as service business is concerned, I think we are on track, which will be almost more than 100% revenue will be generated through the service business, which contributes around 20% of our overall revenue. Whereas, EPC is concerned, the projects which were at the engineering phase, the engineering and procurement phase, the work went on. But as far as construction is concerned, not only in India, but across various geographies, probably we had, almost a 2 months gap. Whereas some clients were, there where we could get the permission to, continue the construction. Mm. So in the June, the construction activity has started. But yes, as and when we have started this activity, there are challenges which with respect to the migrant labor, okay, with respect to the raw materials. Right. And I find that probably, we are now progressing well compared to June. July is definitely a better. And going ahead, although it would be difficult to hazard any numbers, but definitely we feel that things will improve.
Numbers, Mr. Chopra, numbers. You said that 20% of your revenue, which is your services business, is likely to do well. 100% of revenues out there coming by. The remaining 80%, what sort of revenues have you recognized in the first quarter? And you had a jump that we saw in your receivables by the end of the fourth quarter. In the presentation, you said that you've received part of it. Where does that number stand at? The revenues that you've recognized in the first quarter and the receivables, where does that stand at?
See, we have not yet finalized our revenues for the first quarter. We are still in the process of, consolidating. As you know, we are spread across 22 subsidiaries. So we are still in the process. So it would be premature for me to give any numbers as far as Q1 is concerned, right? So I don't think we'll be able to give the numbers of the Q1 at this stage. I think next time whenever we interact, we'll definitely be giving you the numbers of Q1.
We'll look forward to that then. For the last year, you said your quarter four numbers were quite good. But earlier in the year, you were looking at nearly around 3,000 crores in terms of revenues. You've ended up with the number closer to around 2,600 crores. Now, given the kind of, disruptions we've had in the first quarter, and we could see part impact in the second quarter as well. So in terms of revenue for the coming year, what kind of a target do you have in mind?
See, this year, because of the unpredictability, because we find that one place there's a lockdown, there unlock is there, unlock conditions are also varying from place to place. So this year, we are not giving any guidance as of now. But I think by the time we, H1 is over, we'll have a much clearer picture and we'll be able to give the guidance for the next year. As far as operating margins are concerned, I think in the last year, it is very clear that we have improved upon our operating margins. And as far as our receivables are concerned, what you mentioned is it has been a little higher. But whatever is little higher, I think that's only primarily from one particular project. And we have already mentioned that majority of it is collected in the first quarter.
Can you give us that number? You said majority of it is collected. From the numbers that I can see
of
here.
Yeah.
So from the numbers that I can see here, your receivables are close to 426 crores. This is a near 20% jump that we saw year on year. What is the number now?
See, we have already given you the first year, the numbers of the last financial year. As far as Q1 is concerned, as I told you, we have not frozen the numbers as yet.
Okay, and you're saying that one client contributes how much to the total receivables? If you can quantify that, because if that client starts paying, then your receivables come down drastically. So could you quantify that?
I think we have almost, you know, had around 150 crores. I think close to 100 crores is already received, which you saw a spike in the month of March because of that. So I think Q1, definitely there will be improvement as far as total receivables are concerned.
All right. Fair point there, sir. Thanks a lot for stopping by. So if all things remain same, maybe your receivables are back to around that 350 crore sort of levels, given that you've received 100 crores. But we'll speak to you at a time when you can reveal more numbers. Wishing you good luck for the remainder of this year. Let's take a short break. Come back. We have another management lined up for you. The management of Wellspun Corp joins us on the other side.